Frustrated locals fed up with flying foxes have had their air horns seized in raids by officials. Amber Austin Wright joins us now from Southport. And Amber, they're now pleading with the authorities to show common sense.
Yeah, Georgie, residents feel the state government's response to these air horns has been over the top. They feel there's been a breakdown in communication with the authorities. They've made it clear to us today that they don't want to hurt the bats, but they can't keep living with them like this. Now, sunrise and sunset are when the bats are out and about, and right now we have seen hundreds flying around. They're noisy, they're smelly, and this is what locals are facing every day. Now, they feel there's no escape unless they can work together with the state government to come up with some sort of management plan. But so far, they've been threatened with fines and jail terms.
First came the bats, and now more unwanted visitors have turned up at Robin Burgess's Southport home. Armed with search warrants, this time it was officers from the Department of Environment and Resource Management.
I was surprised that they didn't send somebody to just speak to me.
She and her husband were forced to hand over air horns they've been using to fend off an invasion of bats in the neighbourhood. After Southport residents went public with their campaign earlier this week.
It was about me being an unauthorised person attempting to move bats from a roost.
The raid comes as the state struggles to cope with the bat population explosion and the deadly Hendra virus. Residents have had enough.
Oh, there's hundreds. At night time, it's just the sky's just black with them.
They're noisy and they poo everywhere.
Residents are being warned they could face jail or $100,000 fines if they persist in trying to frighten off the flying foxes.
And these penalties are really quite extreme.
Frustrated neighbours have accused the state government of putting disease-ridden bats before humans.
Power to her. I think it's fantastic that she's brought it to light.
Sorry, I didn't know that I wasn't allowed to blast a horn. Probably wasn't allowed to throw the rubber snakes in there or anything else either.
They want the government to work with them, not against them.
I really have to discourage people from taking the law into their own hands. These sorts of actions can't be part of the solution.
Rather than coming down with a heavy-handed, big-stick approach, what the government should be doing here is actually consulting.
Robin is just waiting to see what happens next. On the Gold Coast, Amber Austin-Wright, 10 News.